Cogito ergo sum. I think, therefore I am. Or the more accurate translation of René Descartes' French quote, I am thinking, therefore I do exist. My topic today has a lot to do with this quote and truly understanding its meaning. It's easy looking out at the world around us and assuming that every inch of it is real. But this quote says that only ourselves, only our consciousness can be guaranteed as true. But what about the rest of the world? Does it truly exist? To answer this question, I want to start simply. How do we experience the world around us? The answer is very simple and is often taught in primary schools, our five senses: sight, smell, sound, taste, and touch. Through these senses, we experience the world around us. If we were to remove one of these senses, our experience would be vastly different. No sight would mean no color. No sound would mean no timbre and no music. No smell would mean no fragrance. A blind person's experience of the world is vastly incomplete with just their four senses. But is five the maximum senses that can exist? Is it so hard to believe that if we were to add a sense, there would be a whole new experience that we could not even imagine? There could be so many more senses, each with their own unique experiences, which begs the question, how little of the world around us do we seriously experience with just our five senses? But even these five senses are complicated beyond the highest degree on a biological level. For example, your eyes use rod and cone and many other types of cells to convert light into electrical signals. But I don't think you understand how complex that really is. Color, which is impossible to describe to those who are blind and don't experience it, our eyes describe perfectly in binary signal. This is the same for all our other senses. They take this complex qualitative experience and convert it into simple electrical signals. That is the purpose of our sensory organs. And if I were to remove your eyes, theoretically of course, and replace them with circuits that clicked at the same speed as your retina, you would not be able to tell the difference. You would experience vision just like every single one of us, but you wouldn't see. Because vision is experienced not as light hits the eye, but as the electrical signals reach our brain. It is only when it reaches the brain is this information understood, experienced, and processed. If we were to stop just before this moment, all our senses have been converted into electrical signals, but they're traveling, yet to reach their intended location in the brain. The thing is, our brain is not only blind, but it's senseless. It cannot see, hear, touch, taste, or smell. Yet from these signals, it creates a vast world, both beautiful and scary. This is a really important point that I need you to understand because it means our brain is making a lot of guesses. In fact, all of what we experience is our brain's generated guesswork based on secondary, impure signals about the world around us, which means it could make mistakes and it could tell lies. For example, you've been in a bad accident and you've lost your leg. It's had to have been amputated. All the signals encoding touch of your left leg are suddenly silent, but your brain doesn't stop guessing. A phenomenon known as the phantom limb develops. The vast majority of people who've lost a limb can still feel it in complete lifelike detail. And in most cases, these phantom limbs are also extremely painful. We all assume pain to be a reaction to an injury. So why is there not only touch, but pain in the part of a body that cannot be hurt because it doesn't exist? The answer is that despite your leg being lost, the somatosensory strip in your brain still remains. Essentially, your brain still assumes that your leg exists. So whether or not it really does doesn't matter, because according to your brain, you should feel touch, and so you do feel touch. This really shows the control our brain has over our realities. And this isn't exclusive to touch either. Tinnitus is the phantom hearing sensation and has many parallels to phantom limb. For vision, you could argue hallucinations are the same. The Anton Babinski syndrome describes a blind person who, to put it simply, imagines vision. If you ask them about the room they were in, ask them questions about the room they were in, they would begin to confabulate. They would lie to your face. Their brains have them tricked, believing in a boundless world created purely by the design of their own brains. Imagine a brain blind and imagining a world to see based on sounds, smells, feelings, and guesses. Imagine if this same patient had phantom limb and phantom hearing. Imagine if the brain had no sensory information at all. If we were to blockade the brain so that no senses could ever enter, could you begin to imagine your brain alone creating a world around itself? The warm smell of pine, the sound of birds, the vast green of a forest, all created by a brain in a cold, dark, empty cell. But remember, I think, therefore I am. This means not all of you is gone. We can be guaranteed that there is a part of us, a tiny thinking thing in our brain that still does exist. No matter if everything we see is a dream, or if everything we see is nothing more and nothing less than reality, we can be guaranteed that there is at least a part of us that does exist and does truly experience. That is what René Descartes meant. And I know that sounds bad, but if you think about it, it shows the power you have. As the controller of your own senses, you're the creator of your own reality and the author of your own story. Thank you.